Seventh game's done. I'll tell you what, for 10 cents, I'd be down on the ice playing for either team.
I've got a loony. Do you think you could go for 10?
I wouldn't want to leave you up there all alone, but believe me, I'd do it if I had the chance.
The puck goes back to the net where it's picked up by Ronning. Ronning has his pass cut off by Roberts from a sharp angle. The shot is right on, and McLean has it in his pass. Fleury goes to the corner after, throws it out front, and it's intercepted, and back comes Trevor Linden, the captain of the Canucks. Linden, a feed for Burry. Burry going in. Oh! And moving across the net with him was Vernon, and then Burry lost control of the puck. What a glorious opportunity for Pavel Burry. And as he moved across the net with Vernon, he lost control. For Roberts. Roberts throws it in front of the net. They score! Burry!
Well, yesterday, Theron Fleury said that these are games where heroes are made. And I want to be one of those heroes. What a tremendous play. The simple play, it starts out fighting the puck out 3 feet inside your blue line. Watch his hand-eye coordination as Fleury takes it facing north, turns around south, and bats it. A bouncing puck behind McLean. Not much you can do about that if you're a goalie. If you're defending against Fleury, you did just about all you could do. A tremendous effort, making the simple play, fighting the puck out over the blue line, and then Roberts dumping in at the net gives Calgary the first goal in this hockey game.
And they are doing an aggressive job of forechecking. Drop pass now for Courtnell. Courtnell couldn't wind up. The puck goes over to Burry. Burry has it at the point. Reflected to Lume. Lume lets the shot go. Through traffic, the rebound. Burry scores. Lume's shot from the point was stopped by Mike Vernon, and Burry grabbed the rebound for his second goal of the postseason.
Although Vernon is over there to make an attempt, Burry has got all kinds of net. And not only is that happiness on his face, a lot of relief there too. Burry's second goal of this series.
Knocked away, back comes Craven. Long shot is blocked, the puck in front, they score! Jeff Courtnell pounced on the loose puck in front and slipped it past Mike Vernon for a 2-1 lead.
Well, think about the three goals we've seen so far. Fleury driving to the net, a shot in, jamming in front of the Vancouver power play, and Craven here shoots the puck at the net, makes a simple play, and charging in for a rebound, Courtnell is rewarded.
To McIntyre. Brown jumps up in the play, then McIntyre is decked by McInnes. Back comes Titov. Titov for Reichel. Reichel to Fleury. Fleury takes a shot, the rebound, and Reichel fired it wide. Fleury races down the right side against Hedekin. Fleury still has it out front. McInnes fired it wide. Courtnell working against McInnes. Courtnell takes some time and then decides to take it back into the center ice area. Here he comes again. Courtnell over to Lume. A shot just wide. Ronning, who was serving the additional minor, is on the ice. Patrick taken in against the boards by Hedekin. Kissio has it. He throws it in front. They score! Stern and Roberts were both in front of the net, and it may have bounced in off one of them.
Well, that's 4 for 4, Don. We talked about simplicity at the start of this game. And Calgary has been making the simple play from the start of the hockey game, shooting the puck at the net whenever they don't have anywhere else to go. Let's see if we can tell whether it hit anybody or not. You'll see it come from the right side of your screen, right off of Stern's stick. I'm not even sure that Stern moved his stick. When you stand in front of the net and you know that guys are going to be shooting, you got an opportunity to score, and Stern with his second and the second of the game to tie it in the second period.
But Linden still takes him in against the boards, couldn't get it out front to Burry. Burry reaches for the puck. It was beyond him. Fleury starts away. He has Sullivan and Titov with him. Fleury winds, he scores!
Well, teams always look for players that perform in big games under pressure. Fleury set it, and it's the second time he's done it. Merzen keeps him to the outside. And McLean does not get his legs closed in time. All the goalie wants is for the defenseman to push the shooter so that he can play the angle. I'm not sure that Fleury would pick that spot, but once again, Calgary is clearly demonstrating that when they've got a choice, they're making the simple play and shooting the puck. Fleury with a huge goal that gives Calgary their second lead of the hockey game.
Tees off for Sullivan, Sullivan to Walls. Walls with Zalapski moving up. Walls shoots, he at the post, and Zalapski fanned on the rebound. Calgary at full strength with Zalapski coming down, flipping it in front, and it's broken up by Babich. And Zalapski is hurt in behind the Vancouver net, and he is barely moving as he had his feet taken out from under him.
Neuendijk will stay with Zalapski right to the bench, and Bearcat, I'll guarantee, has got a grip on the back of Zalapski's pants, because when you've been dinged like this, all of a sudden you can lose it again.
Bure trying to free himself from Yanni. Cartneau for Linden. Linden redirects it, and Vernon alertly moved across with him. Here's Brown winding up. His shot, a weak one, blocked by a sprawling Patrick. Fleury steps into Brown. Linden for Cartneau. Good save by Vernon. And a whistle and a penalty call with 8.8 seconds remaining. Yes, Theron Fleury has scored two goals, including the go-ahead goal, and now it's Trevor Linden who is down.
And I think, Don, that Koharski has assessed a high sticking penalty. 1 minute and 30 seconds remaining on the penalty to Trent Yanni.
Bure has it for Brown. Brown over to Lume. Lume up front for Cortnell as it was centered, and Vernon made the save. Cortnell took a perfect feed from Trevor Linden. Now it's Lume with Bure in front of the net, letting the shot go, and Bure failed to redirect it. Lume will try again. He moves in over to Brown. Brown back to Lume. Lume can't shoot it. Back to Brown. He faked the shot. Moves in. Now decides to go back to Lume, to Linden in front of the net, and a diving save is made. Zalapski trying to stay with him. Bure takes it back to the point. Here's Adams cutting for the net. He scores! Greg Adams has tied it with 3:37 remaining.
Adams, who missed a couple of games with an injury after taking a shot from Bure, drives to the net, and as we said in the games that he has played, this guy is a lot stronger than he looks. Drive to the net, you never know what can happen. Adams gets position and hardly takes a shot, but somehow the puck finds its way in, and Vancouver now is going through the same thought process in their mind. If you said it would be tied with 3:37 remaining, we would have taken it. Now let's see if we can find an edge, and all of a sudden, not unlike a coin toss at the start of this game, the odds become that much closer, and we've got ourselves a wagon race here at the Saddle Bowl.
Are we headed for a third straight overtime game? Here comes Yanni. Yanni falls. Babich picks up the loose puck. Babich moves it ahead to Mimesil. Two on one with Didick. A drop pass for Ronning. Ronning moving in. Couldn't get the shot away.
You get joking in practice when there's a three-on-one and you leave the defenseman back and you're not too concerned because it doesn't affect the outcome of a game. Guys regularly yell, spread out! Well, Kevin Dahl found a way to spread out here.
In this seventh game. Drop pass, McKinnon's with a shot! McLean got a piece of it. Neuendijk in the corner. Back to the point, McKinnon with a rocket. That hit Neuendijk, and Neuendijk did a good job keeping it onside. Walls up front for Roberts. He's knocked down. 8 seconds left. Reichel fires it to the corner, and this game is headed for overtime, folks. The third time, the third consecutive game, the extra time has been required. Cortnell took a swipe at it. Craven has it again. Craven shoots. Vernon makes the save. Roberts moves it ahead to Fleury. Here he comes with Reichel. Fleury for Reichel. Great save.
Well, Don, I pressed the silence switch because you should have heard what I said after that save. Unbelievable. Perfect pass. McLean is there. And with the bottom foot, he kicks this puck out. Look at all the net that Reichel has. Goes back to where McLean is. Had a little bit more room. Didn't take advantage of it. Great pass by Fleury. Better save by McLean.
Oh, a shot from the faceoff by Mimesso. Hit the post. 2:23 remaining in this first overtime. Back to the line for Didick. In front for Mimesso. And Mimesso was checked there by Musil. Oh, Yanni hammers Jalonen against the boards. Ronning turns in the corner. Ronning behind the net. Ronning throws it in front. Vernon wasn't sure for a moment where the puck was. 8 seconds remaining in this first overtime period. And folks, we have got a second overtime session coming up here at the Olympic Saddledome. Linden to Adams. Adams is tied up as he tried to go to the corner after it. Cruz has it now. He takes a hit along the boards from Linden. Brown ahead for Burry. Burry going in. He scores! Pavel Burry has won it for the Vancouver Canucks. It's a triple overtime hat trick for Vancouver.
Well, that has silenced all but the crowd that came in from Vancouver for this game, and there will be smiles ear to ear. What a huge goal for Vancouver. We talked about the pressure on this hockey team and on the Calgary Flames. Well, Burry found a way to break loose. And this hockey game is over. The series is over. Vancouver will be playing Dallas. Toronto will be playing San Jose. What a huge goal by Burry. This is one that Vancouver fans will remember just as long as Flame fans remembered Joel Otto's goal in 1989.
There's the head-to-head, 5-1-0 for the Rangers, but it must be pointed out that Jim Schoenfeld didn't come aboard till late, and both teams made several roster moves during the season, so you can really disregard the regular season matchup as Schoenfeld tries to give one last pep talk to the boys.
That's right. These two teams are different teams than the regular season. There's a different coach right there, Jim Schoenfeld. He coached against the Rangers twice. They won one and lost one. But this guy right here, Dale Hunter, back in the lineup will make a tremendous difference for Washington. The Hunter factor, if you want to call it that. What intensity, what grit this guy has.
Now, you may not like how he plays the game, but he is an integral part, always has been, of this Washington Capitals team since coming over from Quebec. All right, we're underway here at Madison Square Garden. Neither team will like the shape of the ice, but they both have to play on it, and a lot at stake. And here comes Mark Messier. He's in alone, and a save by Beaupre. 15 seconds into the game, and Messier's got a break.
Unbelievable.
Rangers hustling to the corner in the person of Glenn Anderson, wearing number 36, not his number 9 that he wore in Toronto. Messier, they were both teammates with those powerful Edmonton Oilers teams. Graham's back to Messier. A shot! Oh, he thought it went into the fans, but it hit the outside of the post. Ended up behind the net. And no argument from Kovalev. Kevin Lowe in the slot. Winder up. Hit traffic in front. Well, the Rangers are unloading all the guns early.
That's for sure. I think Kerry Gregson was playing a little even up there after Noonan with the high stick on Anderson.
Stefan Matteau's shot comes back to the blue line. Matteau now screening in front. Hatcher's on him. Kovalev in the corner. Matteau, and he scores! Stefan Matteau with a tip-in of a bad angle shot from Kovalev. Schoenfeld may wonder where that came from, but it counts.
This one pretty much surprised everybody. There's Kovalev along the board. The blind pass in front. There's Matteau. Look at that. Right out of the air. Perfect eye-hand coordination on that one. He bunted that one in the far side. Stefan Matteau. Schoenfeld may have started it, and then Gregson just went over to Keenan to
Michael Pavanka. He's in alone. Goes to the forehand. He scores! Michael Pavanka. Carry away 22 seconds between goals. A minute to go, and the penalty to Joe Riki of Washington. Here comes Kovalev on the wing. 1-1 tie. Kovalev is hauled down. No penalty call. Oh, he was hauled down good by Dave Poulin. Leach in the slot. Waves at it. Down in the Ranger zone.
Well, things have quieted down somewhat now. Sometimes the intensity level lasts only a minute or two, sometimes about 10 minutes. And after the 10-minute mark, things have kind of settled down now into the track we're going to see until the next goal is scored.
Coach in the corner to the right of Volpre. Pavich mucking and grinding. He does that as well as anybody in the league. Right in front. Craig McTavish did most of the work on that one.
Did he ever. Tremendous effort by Craig McTavish. And the Rangers are starting to establish their game plan here. McTavish doing the work along the boards. And then Noonan got a couple of free whacks in front.
Welcome back to Madison Square Garden in New York, everyone. Period number two, game one. Eastern Conference semis. Watch. Turnover at center ice just outside the zone. And a turnover inside just a moment ago. Bondra behind the net. Tries to wrap around. And Richter, Johnny on the spot, gets there.
Can't keep it still to play well so far.
It is fun to play. It's fun to watch. Lots of action. Like the physical action. This is the sport for you. And friendly score! Watching a capital score on the power play. And I believe it's Kelly Miller. 21 seconds left to go on a 4-on-3. Messier. Ryan Leach lets her rip wide, stick side. Kovalev, Kovalev again. 28 seconds on the power play. Zubov is wide. Zubov gets his own rebound. Cruises in. Around Poulin. Feeds Leach. Score!
Get credit for it.
Well, yeah, let's take that graphic down until we get an official announcement. That puck changed directions a couple of times. We'll have to wait and see who they go. Well, they give it to Brian Leach. All right. I'm sure they'll look at the tape and the cabbage in the corner. Here come the Rangers in front. Pilot score! To Brian Noonan, who took advantage of traffic in front, came out of the corner and ripped it. Garden in New York, we're getting set for the third period of game one of the Eastern Conference semis on ESPN2's coverage of NHL Fire and Ice.
Zubov deserves an awful lot of credit, but I still think Brian Leach is the go-to guy. We'll have to watch.
Marmer again. Seven score! The two former Chicago Blackhawks, Fred Gilbert and Steve Larmer, conspire to give the Rangers a three-goal lead. The goal goes to Gilbert.
Great puck control by the New York Rangers down low. Larmer got it to Gilbert, and the Washington defense has struggled in front of their own goaltender. See the play develop here. There's Larmer. He'll control the puck, and the switch off from the front of the net to the corners by the Washington defense have hurt them. There's Gilbert. He got one swipe at it. That's all he needed.
Tight defensively. Capitals are trying out there, but there are no holes. And the Rangers are lining up across their own blue line. They can't get it across effectively. They can't get anything done offensively the way they want to.
Sylvain Coltang from the right point, and Richter goes down to make the center rebound. They score. Mike Ridley turns around on the backhand and makes it a two-goal Ranger lead. Trying to hit number 10, Kelly Miller with it. Coté has three assists for Washington tonight. Another shot! Breaking in was Dave Poulin. The Capitals cruising in front now. Kelly Miller and Poulin. Poulin out of the corner. Slaney the shot. He's wide. Kevin Hatcher. This is the best sustained pressure by Washington since early in the second period.
Washington is getting to those loose pucks.
Oh, speaking about loose pucks, here's Messier shorthanded. He scores!
Messier, that was perfect. At high speed, make your move decisively, make a crisp shot, it goes in the net.
Takes it away, Ryan Leach. Gives it up to Graves. Graves is all alone, goes to the backhand, and somehow he doesn't get it on goal.
Rattlers, they should be.
They'll count it down now. Game one goes to New York. And tempers are flaring. Dale Hunter at the whistle. He and Sergei Zubov, but quickly separated. However, another scrum.
Chris Ditch and Kevin Lowe.
This is always sad to see at the end of a contest. Accomplishes nothing.
I think so. A pretty solid game by the New York Rangers. You can't take anything away from them. Richter was solid. Everybody was solid.
He could end it. One of those six Vancouver defense.
Linden jumping on the puck right off the bat and coming in hard. Linden looking back, gets it to the line. Here's a shot by Babbage. Oh, the big rebound!
The Eastern Conference Final from a packed house at the Meadowlands at East Rutherford, New Jersey. The Devils and the New York Rangers face off at center. Bobby Carpenter and Mark Messier. Goaltenders tonight, and they've both been magnificent.
Well, you know that the New York Rangers guys are saying to Mike Richter, listen, if you've got one more I can win this one by myself kind of game in you this season, now's the time, big boy. As far as Martin Brodeur is concerned, he hasn't been a factor in the last two games.
Who really has the more pressure on them tonight? Tommy Abelin, saved by Richter. Rebound, saved by Richter on Bobby Carpenter. To Bernie Nichols, Nichols and Richie. Nichols, saved by Richter. And Mike Richter's holding the fort right now for the New York Rangers. Zalapuka leaves it for Billy Guerin. Save made again. Richter looks like he's on, but he's really getting challenged. These are tough shots. Here's Stevens with Zalapuka. Zalapuka gets by one man. Made again by Richter. Both teams are a little tentative here, feeling each other and maybe even more importantly themselves out, not wanting to make any big mistakes and kind of both standing each other up all over the ice. A little slide of Fetisov right there. He loves to do this. It drives coaches crazy, but that's how they played it on Central Red Army.
Gee, how come? You how come that drives coaches crazy?
No other hockey system uses it, I'll tell you that. Niedermeyer centering. Look out! Score! It went off a Rangers stick, deflected in front, 1-0 Devils.
The Devils have gotten in front of so many shots, more and more each game.
Bobby Holik, great shot, rebound, loose, shot, deflected by Doug Lidstern, a penalty coming up on the Rangers. Center, Niedermeyer, scores! Nichols went down to one knee just to tie it up. And the first period is over. New Jersey 2, Rangers nothing. No team, neither of these teams, has overcome a two-goal deficit in this series. Power play continues for the New York Rangers. He up to the point, Niedermeyer has got a goal and an assist. Wait, screen shot, Richter, great save. He had all kinds of people in front of him on Niedermeyer's shot from the point. Kovalev backs it up for Lowe. Notice how the pace of this game. Down, down, down. That's to the Devil's advantage.
And even when the Ranger, look at this.
McLean, save made by Richter. Ernie Nichols, save made Richter. Richey over the net.
As the Devils had gone 6 minutes without a scoring chance, but here is one. Bernie Nichols with the high shot. Stefan Richey did a good job to knock it down, and then Mike Richter had to make a second save on a sharp angle.
Zalapukin and Garin. Zalapukin, save made by Richter. Zuboff behind the net. Minute 56 to go in the second period. Messier at center, tied up by Bobby Carpenter. Again, Billy Garin the puck. Messier moves in. Mike Messier comes. Rangers need one. Desperately, Kovalev all alone. Kovalev shot. He scores! They got one! We will now have a game worthy of Game 6 of the Conference Final.
Boy, you bet. You bet we will. Yep, Neil Smith, there is life. There is life. All right, here's what happened in the neutral zone. The Devils at one point with pretty good possession of the puck. Finally, it's broken up, all right? When they come this way, if we stop right here, the Devils got confused over in this side and they got caught. Watch when the Rangers come this way, the puck support. See how many Rangers come to this side? There are three Rangers around the puck. That's why they were able to make the play, and that's what they hadn't done up until that point.
Kovalev makes it a 2-1 game.
Here's a look at the goal. We're going to show it to you again. See three Rangers in that shot. They had puck support on that side. Kovalev was on the side, so Messier carried the puck right to him. Nobody ended up getting to Kovalev in time. Terrific shot just inside the long post. Now the Rangers can settle down.
We have completed two. If the Rangers could come back and win this game, there will be a game seven. Kovalev's the man who put it in at 18-19, and after two, it's the Devils two and the Rangers one with a third period yet to come. Third period, game six. The New Jersey Devils lead in the series 3-2 and can wrap it up here. Driver tried the man up. Lipster got the puck. Jim Dowd back in front. Zalapukin saved by Richter. Rebound went wide.
You can tell the Rangers have the jump and want to go for it.
Carpenter cutting to the net. Tom Troisky blocked by Doug Lipster, who has played a very good game. Lipster's first game of the playoffs. Hadn't played since the last game of the regular season. Lipster's seen some ice time and has been effective. Kovalev moving in. Kovalev to Messier. Messier shot. Score! Just throw the clicker away. You got all you'll need right here.
What a play. The Rangers with some speed through the neutral zone. When they have speed through the neutral zone, they are a dangerous team. And Mark Messier is as dangerous as they come. The man that proclaimed, "We will win game six," has just tied it. All of the sports sections in New York had Mark Messier's quote plastered all over them. "We will win game six," and the Rangers are tied now, 2-2.
Mike Richter, he held the fort in the first period for this team.
Boy, when it's on the line, if you could pick a guy in the National Hockey League to have on your side, I bet you half the general managers would draft this guy for one game, one big time.
Kovalev covering up. We're in a 4-on-4, remember. Leach moving it in. Leach drops it. Kovalev again. Save, Brodeur, rebound, score! Mark Messier gets his second goal! The Rangers lead 3-2!
Are you the real Mark Messier? Yes, I am. How about it? Kovalev's shot was not one that Brodeur could squeeze off. the rebound to Messier, and the Rangers have taken the lead.
There is no greater theater than sports, and Mark Messier is writing the stuff of which legends are made. Bernie Nichols looks behind him. Messier won the draw. Lidstra cleared it around. John McClain center for the empty net. Mark Messier, do you believe it? Do you believe it? He said we will win game six. He has just picked up the hat trick.
The Devils were so close, and now they are so, so far. What a series, what a series.
He won the draw?
Yes, that was his 22nd win in 31 draws. And then he just nailed, he even landed that shot flat, just in case it was a pass for somebody. And the boys were waiting for him with open arms. They had all congregated at one end of the bench to welcome him back. What a performance. I think I said something before the game about him being genetically perfect for this kind of situation. Somehow, Mark Messier becomes a larger-than-life person when the situation calls for it and warrants it. Yep, that's what he said yesterday in all of the papers. We'll win.
If you say that in New York, the whole world knows. You better be ready.
Gosh.
This is really the stuff of which sports history are made of. Personally for him, for the New York Rangers, if indeed this is to be their year, it's the kind of thing that makes you believe destiny is really there on your bench. His first career playoff hat trick. Game 7, Madison Square Garden, Friday night. The New York Rangers have beaten the Devils 4-2.
This is the 7th and deciding game of the Eastern Conference Final. The New York Rangers taking on the New Jersey Devils on the Rangers board at Rye. The Rangers and Devils 3 games apiece, and waiting are the Vancouver Canucks. And tonight, live at Madison Square Garden, it's game 7 for the right to move on for the Stanley Cup Final. So what do you look for in game 7? Number one, you look for leadership. And certainly both teams have outstanding leaders, and they'll be looking for them to come through tonight.
Well, Mark Messier, of course, is the number one man for the Rangers. He's 33 years of age. He has won 5 Stanley Cups. Only Wayne Gretzky has more points in playoff action than does Messier. Scotty Stevens is 29 years of age. He hasn't had a great series to this point. However, you can take these numbers. They don't mean much right now other than the fact that they've gotten their teams to this point. This game is important to the two leaders.
There is no doubt that in a 7th game, much more than any game in a series, the pressure lands on the goaltenders. You well know that, John.
That's exactly right. Mike Richter's a little older, 27 years of age, than is Brodeur. Richter this season has played 11 games, including regular season, against the Devils. He's only given up 20 goals, if you can imagine. He has gotten better. And as far as Brodeur goes, as we mentioned, 22 years of age, I don't know if he's old enough to understand what the pressure is of this game. And I fully expect both goaltenders to play well.
Now, what about the emotion coming off game 6, John? How will it affect the two teams?
Well, I think more than anything else, it's already affected this building. These fans are more ready now than they've been for any game in this series. You can sense it just by listening and turning and looking.
You can hear the noise building. The New York Rangers are hitting the ice. There's Captain Mark Messier, Ryan Leach.
Now let's go to center ice for the singing of our national anthem. And here is Mr. John Amorante. Madison Square Garden is ready. And so are the New Jersey Devils and New York Rangers.
And here we go. Same matchup, Carpenter and Messier.
Messier with Graves and Anderson, Leach and Bukubun. Bukubun back after the one-game suspension. Richey, nice moves, takes the shot and a save by Richter.
Very quick pace and a disciplined pace. Changes, no offsides, everything very smart early.
Puck up the boards to Chorsky. Lemieux, far right side, gets the pass. Moves it on Leach, hip check, sends him flying.
Leach hits a lot better than people give him credit for, and there's an example of it. Hitting Claude Lemieux.
Loose puck, Guerin gets to it. Guerin shoots, save, Richter. Good hustle by Billy Guerin for the scoring chance. Line, tries to get it through to Matteau, but Holik blocked it. Oh. And he's run into by Kovalov with a hard hit. Back the other way, Launer. Gave it up to Peluso. And Lott comes into the devil zone with 6:15 to go in the first and still no score. Graves with the hit on Stevens, but Stevens was able to release. Nichols sends it in. This will be an icing on the Devils. Zuboff makes the touch and icing is called.
The fans should stand and cheer. It doesn't get any better. We're seeing great action by two great teams having a great season in a seventh game. Sam, the hitting couldn't be any harder. The pace can't be any faster, and it can't be much cleaner. My goodness, this is just fabulous action.
Moves it to Carpenter and on to Chorsky. Bukubun hits Chorsky and down he goes.
See, Bukubun not even think about the puck. He had a chance to play the puck. He decided to take the body instead. This period was about as close as it gets. Two great teams in a game seven played a very close first period. Maybe Bobby Carpenter had the best scoring chance with the 2-on-1. He took his time, and he missed the net on the play, up over top of the crossbar. Good goaltending, great hitting, great intensity, great discipline. The referee let him play. You got to love it.
Leach moves down with the puck. Got a pick from Messier. He's picked up there by Guerin. Backhand scores! Brian Leach gives the Rangers a 1-0 lead.
And they score the goal, not against the checking unit of the Devils, not against the checking line. Rangers win the draw. Watch the 360 right here to avoid his checker, Billy Guerin. And
Lowe gets the stick into the midsection. Pass for Nichols. Save made by Richter.
Oh, what a play by Richey. Baby, what a save again by Richter.
Yeah, gives it away to Guerin. He moves in. Saved by Richter, and he holds on.
Oh, the guy is something. Mike Richter is a big game goaltender, folks. And he has had a sensational second period.
Final seconds of the period. They're on their feet at Madison Square Garden. The Rangers will take a lead into the third period. Mike Richter has stopped all 15 Devil shots. The Rangers have gotten one past Martin Brodeur. And at the end of two, the New York Rangers lead the New Jersey Devils 1-0. Driver works it down the boards. Zalapukin's pass blocked by Leach. Out to Matteau, moving with Nemchinov. Matteau waits, no shots on goal for the Devils on the power play, and the teams are back at full strength. The 11:25 to go in the third, and the crowd on its feet. This lead to Guerin. Guerin on Wells. Guerin is stopped by Richter, and it rolls wide as the net is knocked off on the collision. Another fabulous play by Guerin. Another great save by Richter, who gets up.
He's a little fired up, absolutely.
Each other. Guerin reaching for the puck. Rangers don't see it. Shot went wide. Guerin centered. Save Richter on a deflection. Here's a chance for Guerin. He's forced back by Leach. Leach takes it away. Moves it up the boards. Albelin stops it at the line and keeps it in. Guerin shoots. Deflection. Save Richter. Off Jim Dowd. Oh, Mike Richter. What a show he's putting on with 20 saves, keeping the Devils away on all kinds of shots.
The Devils standing again. I don't know why they sit down. This game's so good, they've been on their feet all game long.
Devils move it out. Chorsky for McClain. Leach knocks it aside. Every other name mentioned seems to be Leach. Albelin takes the pass. Leach stops it at the line.
Every time the Devils try to get offense, try to come as a unit, Leach breaks it up. Every time it's Leach, he's everywhere.
On Messier for the draw. Standoff in the circle. Messier moves it. Marmer can't clear. Nichols shoots. Save Richter.
and he holds on, gets the whistle. 16.4 seconds remaining as Mike Richter makes his first save in quite a while.
The Devils
back behind the net, driven around by Bukaboom. Driver blocks it. Larmer is on him. Richet centers. Stopped by Richter. The Devils score! They have tied it! The Devils have tied it with 7.7 seconds to go!
Overtime.
Madison Square Garden fans are stunned. We are going to overtime. A stunned silence. The Rangers were 7.7 seconds away from the Stanley Cup Final. And now the teams are all even.
The race is on for the puck. Guerin and Leach. Richter goes out.
Guerin takes it away. Try to put it in front of his block by Leach. Richter with a dangerous move in overtime.
Look at Mike Richter. He won the battle to the puck, but Brian Leach, who was thinking, went back and played goal while Mike Richter was out of the goal.
Here's a two-on-one for the Devils. McKay and Holík. McKay for Holík, and it's chipped out and saved by Richter.
Oh, baby, did Richter get it done. Look at Richter's stick. What a brilliant play by Richter, and then he held on to the loose puck.
Lines up, drives it on goal. A bouncer stopped by Richter.
Oh, man. Double overtime
for the third time in this series. Game seven to decide who will remain alive in the Stanley Cup Championship Tournament. Line, Bruce Driver. Pass back. Richet shoots. Save. Richter. Rebound. Where's the puck? It's in the corner. Noonan's got it.
It stays in the Devil's zone. Matteau goes for the puck.
Matteau around the net. Matteau puts it. Score! Score! The Rangers win! The Rangers win! They're going to the finals! The Rangers win!
Do here. It's for the players. He receives his trophy. He'll want his players.
The presentation of the Wales Conference Trophy. And they are going wild at the Garden.
Mark Messier called over the assistant captains. He'll talk to his players. Oh, my goodness.
The chant of we want the cup. We want the cup has gone up.
We're set for game seven of the Eastern Conference Championship. With the winner going on to play the Vancouver Canucks in the Stanley Cup Final. What a spot for a 22-year-old rookie, Martin Brodeur. Actually played in the seventh game against New York 2 years ago in relief. Won the seventh game this year against Buffalo. Mike Richter has never played in the seventh game, but he is an enormous reason why we're here tonight. He helped weather the Devil's storm in game six before the amazing comeback in the third period. Leaving it for Peluso. There's Lipster knocking his man down behind the net. Peluso after it again. Fourth line for New Jersey causing trouble. Here's a pass.
Bobby Holík with a chance. Mike Richter is so quick, so flexible, gets the right toe out to make the save. Full extension, pass goes right through the crease. Out comes the right leg to make the save.
Mark Messier's three-goal performance, of course, the big story of Game 6, but just as big was his previous guarantee that his team would win. Naturally, here in New York, they hark back to Joe Namath, late 60s, the underdog Jets in the AFL. We'll win the Super Bowl. And they did, and they hauled that story out. His performance, they were comparing it. Reggie Jackson, three homers in the series. Babe Ruth pointing for a home run and getting one. Here's Leek twisting a turn and scoring! Bernie Nichols.
Beautiful one-hand pass by Stefan Richer to Nichols. One-hand backhand pass, Richer to Nichols, and Richter right there to make the save.
The fans are into a standing O routine here, and I think you'd almost like to think this is a salute to both these teams. This is a terrific hockey game on the 27th of May. These are the two top teams of the National Hockey League over the long regular season. 112 points for the New York Rangers, 106 for the New Jersey Devils. And they have continued that degree of excellence through until this nail-biter here tonight at Madison Square Garden. And they deserve a lot of credit.
Goes by Holík down the ice. It's been a good line for New Jersey tonight as Peluso crashes into Bukovov, but out comes Gilbert. Nemchinov on the move, the pass!
Holík is trying to come back on Nemchinov. Nemchinov goes right by him, and he doesn't get the pass. The pass comes to Nemchinov on the backhand, and Martin Brodeur keeping his team in this game. Pass on the backhand. Nemchinov chips it through, and it's underneath Brodeur's back leg. Good to be lucky, and lucky to be good. Drag the leg, and Brodeur had it under the pad.
Once again, it's Nichols and Messier on the hot seat as Martin Brodeur cools off. Tied up for the draw, comes the Nichols shot on Richter, and he makes the save. And a quick whistle. Richter wanted to play it so they wouldn't have to deal with the faceoff, but with 16.4 seconds left, they'll have another draw in the Rangers' zone.
Devils are complaining the slow home ice clock here. They think about two extra seconds went off the clock on that whistle. It's hard to hear the whistle. You can't blame the timekeeper on this one. Saved by Richter. Whistle by Bill McCreary, and did the clock run down?
There's confusion here about the time clock. Yes, they put it back to 18.6 from 16.4. The Devils gain a couple of valuable seconds.
Now we're ready, and from the faceoff, tied up again behind the net. Bukovov around the board. Stryver is moved in. Warmer and hit. Centered it. Side of the net. They back away and score. Have tied it.
Bill McCreary just got bumped by Mike Richter, and Richter better be careful or he might not be around for the overtime. Valerie Zalapukin was poking away at the side, and the Devils poised and confident, that's the words they were using to describe their team, getting the kind of respect that they deserve.
Not all the ghosts have been exercised yet.
Claude Lemieux throws it out. Zalapukin has a crack at it. It's under Mike Richter and a second shot. What a save by Richter on the first one. I couldn't believe he got the first one. Zalapukin, the shot. Richter gets the left leg on the first one and then has two cracks at it. And got the second one by him.
And an epic series continues between Jacques Lemaire's New Jersey Devils, Mark Messier's New York Rangers, into overtime with the fans rubbing it back up again. But it's off to the line, but not out. Messier in behind the net, looking to center. Kutuzov all over him. Bernie Nichols behind the goal. Up the board, Kukubun pinching, Kovalev shooting, and a big club save by Martin Brodeur. Big move to move to center. He'll clear it back into the New Jersey zone. Abilene, that hit McTavish's stick. It's in front, Newton. Rebound there, Brodeur makes the stop. And we might have had a real argument there. Was the puck knocked down by a high stick?
Shoulder length or higher, Martin Brodeur, good reaction. We didn't see the high stick there. It was knocked down earlier than that, came out in front, and Brodeur with the good reactions to come out and get Brian Noonan.
But we're headed for double OT for the third time in this epic battle. Brian leaps to the line, sends it in deep. Who's going to be the hero and send their team to the Stanley Cup Final? Bukaboom shot! And Brodeur stopped it. Bukaboom kept it in. Kovalev puts it through. Loose in front. And Messier is robbed. And we continue thanks to Martin Brodeur. Best save of the game under the circumstances off Messier.
Oh. Through traffic, fire it at the net. Kovalev just shoots it through. Brodeur can't see it. Can't control the rebound. Messier with the rebound, but Brodeur, we've mentioned it so many times during the series.
Nemchinov, Noonan, and Anderson for New York, and here's Nemchinov. Right wing Anderson, back to Nemchinov, and it's behind him as he was all tied up. Anderson knocked down by McLean as he was about to let fire. Crowd responds, but play continued. Here's Richter with a chance, fires it, Richter, rebound, and it stayed out. As McLean crashed towards the net. Here come the Rangers, Anderson and Noonan. Glenn Anderson firing it right on. Great chances for both teams in the second overtime, and John McLean flips to center.
Bernie Nichols crashing the net, almost had it bounce in off his skates, but just bounced and bounced wide.
Now Matteau is forechecking. Stefan Matteau looks like he'll try coming with the goal.
This is game four of the Stanley Cup Finals, with the New York Rangers leading the Vancouver Canucks 2-1.
The Rangers have outshot the Vancouver Canucks 119-85 through the first three games. Here we go. Messier, Graves, Anderson, Bukaboom, and Leach for the Rangers. Vancouver with Antoski, Hunter, McIntyre, Babich, and Didick. We played 6:20. Jeff Brown has the puck behind the net. Sergio Momesso. Cliff Ronning brings it across with Jelena. Got upended by Bukaboom. Nemchinov back to take the puck. And a penalty call. Rangers send out Messier with Graves. Lowe and Zubov. Linden, Adams, Bure, Brown, and Lume. The puck up to Lume. He turns, fakes the shot. Bure's got it. Out to Lume. Across the Brown. Save Richter. First shot on goal for Vancouver. 1:15 to go in the power play. Lume at the point. Linden sets up Adams. Waits, looking for Bure. Finds Brown. Good save made by Richter.
Look at that. Oh, baby. What a save by Mike Richter.
Jeff Brown takes it back for Vancouver. Bukaboom after the puck. They'll have to play it. Jelena, hard hit on Bukaboom. Kept in by Momesso. Bounces down to Jelena. Try to reverse it, hit the back of the net. Around the net comes Cliff Ronning. Ronning checked by Bukaboom. Ronning keeps moving. Bukaboom stays with him. Ronning puts it in front. Rangers holding. Penalty call. Save Richter. As he made a big save on Ronning.
13:02, the time of the holding call on Adam Graves. Second power play for the Canucks. They're 0-for-1. They had three shots on goal on the first one. Linden, Bure, Lume, Adams, Brown for the power play. Bukaboom and Leach, McTavish and Nemchinov for the Rangers penalty killing. Bukaboom battling Adams. McTavish looking for the puck. Bure gets it to Linden and out to Lume. Now to Linden. He turns. Backhands it down low. Bure got hit with a stick by Bukaboom in the back. Bure is down low. Lume shoots and broke the stick. And a shot is a goal! Trevor Linden scores! And Vancouver takes a 1-0 lead with their first power play goal of the series.
And it's a hard-working power play goal, and this is the best the Canucks have looked in the series.
Trevor Linden had gone 7 games without a goal. Played off the corner boards. Graves pressured by the Canucks, gives it up, and a great shot by Didick is stopped by Richter. Messier racing down. Didick back for it. Over skates. Graves fell down. So did Anderson. Moves it to Messier. Back to Graves. Tries to stuff it in. He got knocked down by Didick. Rather by Babich. Another shot is a save by McLean off of Graves. Momesso clears the zone.
Good shift after giving up the goal for the Rangers. And McLean looks sharp.
Linden's 10th of the playoffs. Tying him for the second most goals of the playoffs with Mark Messier.
Messier got caught for hitting from behind.
The major to Messier is for boarding at 14-17. Greg Adams to Trevor Linden. Doug Lidstra goes over. Lidstra low on with Larmer and Nemchinov. Around the boards to Lume. Nemchinov on him. Deep to Adams. Adams penalty. The penalty coming up on Trevor Linden.
Trevor Linden grabbed a hold of the defenseman's stick.
The back pass intercepted by Bure. Knocked away nicely by Zubov. Leach for Larmer. Bure trying to take it back. He does. Now Murray Craven for Pavel Bure. One-on-one with Zubov. Zubov trying to read him. Bure gets in. And a save made. The rebound score. Cliff Ronning.
And the Rangers' best players will be heard of yet tonight. This is a very young game. Yet.
First period is coming to an end. And that's it. Vancouver Canucks have a 2-0 lead.
Canucks on the power play to start the second period with 45 seconds remaining in the roughing penalty to Esa Tikkanen.
Power play Vancouver, Linden, Adams, Bure, Lume, and Brown. This is Jurke Lume, now Jeff Brown. Linden in the corner. Messier, Graves, Leach, and Bukaboom. Bure shanked the shot. Leach drives it around the boards and out. Lidstra knocked off the puck. Nathan Lafayette checked by Kevin Lowe. Courtnall with the hit on Lidstra. Taken down.
by Lidstrom. Lidstrom will go. Cortinall is really upsetting the Rangers for a big shot. Saved through the screen by Richter. Linden was in front. Adams tied up with Lowe. Anderson takes the puck. Gets it to Nemchinov with plenty of room. He slides it down the ice. 12 seconds remaining in the power play for Vancouver.
Now let's see if the Rangers do kill it off. If they can find a way to generate offense, it's needed.
Pavel Bure, nice pass to John McIntyre. Stopped by Bukubo, but here's Bure! Slid it wide! 2-0, Vancouver leading it. Richter plays it to the boards. Stopped by McIntyre. He moves down. It's knocked away by Leach. Gilbert off the board for McTavish. McTavish with Leach and Koser 3-on-2. Leach looks to the net and shoots. He scores! Brian Leach with his 10th goal of the playoffs. Gives the Rangers, cuts the Rangers deficit to 1. It's 2-1.
Oh, wait till you see this shot. Vancouver was on a rush. And the fans enjoying that. The Rangers are back into it, folks.
Roddick checked by Nemchinov. Keeps it alive. Good practice by Ronning. He cuts in. Roddick shoots. Saved by Richter. Good save by Richter coming out. Lume with a puck. He cuts in. Saved by Richter. Another save by Richter. Another save by Richter. And he made another one. Five saves by Mike Richter. As he shuts the door on the Canucks. Another shot is a kick save by Richter. Great pressure by the Canucks. And Mike Richter stopping them all. Brian Noonan moves in. Stopped by McLean as he's checked by Lume. Matota Leach. Leach moving with a puck. It's knocked loose and taken by Bure. Bure on a breakaway. He's taken down by Leach.
No, will that be a penalty shot?
Let's see. Here's a shot by Adams and a save made by Richter.
Yes.
Penalty shot for Bure. Here comes Bure against Mike Richter. Save by Richter. What a save by Mike Richter to stop Pavel Bure. They're going wild at the Garden. The Rangers here at Pacific Coliseum congratulate Mike Richter on a fabulous save. Zubov to the puck. Stopped by Bure. Zubov looking for an opening. He's hit by Adams. Nemchinov trying to get loose to clear. He can't do it. There's a penalty called on Vancouver.
And Zubov is down and hurting. So it'll be a boarding call.
Graves looking for the puck. Got it back to Leach. Zubov is open. Zubov shoots just wide. Around the boards to Messier. He's whacked by McIntyre. Controls the puck. Feeds Zubov. Zubov fakes. Shoots again. Score! Sergei Zubov! It's a power play goal! And the game is tied! The Rangers head for the locker room tied as Zubov at 19:44 got a power play goal from Messier and Leach. Shots 8 for the Rangers, total 16, 12 Canucks, total 20.
Rangers defensemen have outscored Vancouver defensemen 6-1 in the series to this point. Hedegaard has the one goal for Vancouver and the Rangers have 6. What a difference.
Messier hounding Broughton. Linden moves it across, broken up by Zubov. Graves pushes it ahead and breaks in. He shoots, save McLean. The rebound poked away by McLean from Graves. Cortinall 2-on-1 with Linden. Cortinall blocked by Zubov. Great play by Sergei Zubov. Rangers on a power play. Looking out is Brett Hedekin. Hedekin moving in on Zubov. Hedekin to the net. Hedekin in front. Saved by Richter. Pass to Mavesso. He's picked up by Tikkanen. Craven. Across the Jella that tips it into the Rangers zone. Lowe is with him. Lowe being held and spun around and pulled down and a penalty called. It's on Martin Jelena. Kevin Lowe is pulled down. And Jelena will go with 5:29 to go in the third. Power play Rangers. 1:35 to go on the power play. Coming down to 5 minutes to go. Third period. 2-2 the score. Ryan Leach moves in around Glenn. He turns. He fakes. Kovalev scores! A power play goal! Alexei Kovalev gives the Rangers a 3-2 lead. And the Rangers have the lead for the first time in the game.
I believe they've been up once earlier in the game. Messier wins. Zubov has the puck. What a game. Sergei Zubov has had. Bridget pass. Here's Larver moving in. Larver to the net. Saved by McLean. He got a piece. 2:15 to go in the third.
Bounces off the boards, leeches on and moves it to Zubov. Pressed by Adams, he gets it ahead to Larmer. Larmer looking, shoots in, off a skate, it goes in! It went in off Babich! The Rangers score and lead 4-2!
What a great series of plays here in the third period. It started with Richter. It's been Leach. It's been everybody.
Courtnall against Lidster. Richter gets a stick on it. Nemchinov trying to move it. It's in the corner. Noonan's got the puck, and the Rangers win. The New York Rangers will head home with a chance to win the Stanley Cup on Thursday night at Madison Square Garden.
Believe, folks, believe in this team.
This is the 10th time in NHL history that a Stanley Cup final has gone to seven games. The home team has won seven, the away team has won two. The last time it went to seven games was 1987 when the Edmonton Oilers blew a 3-1 lead in the series and won game seven over the Philadelphia Flyers. The chant of "We want the cup" going up from the crowd here at Madison Square Garden. We are set for the Canadian and American national anthems. I have never heard anything like this. Mike Richter, ready to go. Each goaltender has played every game for their respective team, trying to win number 16 and the championship game. Rangers line up with one change. Nick Kiprios is in. Joey Koser is out. Defense pairing. Doug Lidster remains in the lineup. And of course, Mike Richter starting in goal with Glenn Healy as the backup for Mike Keenan. His fourth Stanley Cup final, looking for his first Stanley Cup championship.
He wants it. Fans are standing already. Oh, wow. Ready. Everybody wants it. Let's watch Mark Messier's first shift.
Messier, Graves, Anderson, Leach, and Bukaboom for the Rangers. McIntyre, Antoski, Hunter, Hedekin, and Brown. Shot fake by Anderson. Takes the shot, deflected, stopped by McClain, clears it aside. Rangers have not scored a first period goal in the last three games. Dangerous play, saved by Richter, and it's knocked loose. Noonan's got it. It bounced down, and they got a shot on Richter, and he made the stop. Messier slowed down by Bore, gets by him. Messier cuts in, still with the puck. Nice pass to Zubov. Zubov feeds Leach. Leach scores! A brilliant passing play by Messier. Zubov with Leach finishing. The Rangers lead 1-0.
Now that's hockey. Mark Messier, you'll see, get control of the puck and power through Bure right there. Now when he gains the zone, he's got to make the smart play. Watch Leach take his time to hit the open net, which he does. Messier's a magnet. When he draws people to him, others are open. Beautiful play by the big boys for the Rangers. Messier with power. Now watch him draw people to him and pass the puck with authority. Now Zubov has his defense partner in on the play, and bingo, it's 1-0. What the Rangers want, if this is their game plan. Dump the puck and cycle and work the Vancouver defense. Try and draw a penalty, but don't get three forwards caught deep across the goal line, in behind the goal net.
Bukaboom's there to stop it. McTavish, penalty upcoming. The That's Rangers it. Working so hard, drew a penalty on the Canucks. First power play of the game to the Rangers.
That's a great shift. Absolutely great. That's exactly what the Rangers talked about.
Zubov and Leach, Messier, Graves, and Kovalov for the Rangers. Kovalov to the puck. Now Graves, he scores! Oh. Adam Graves! It's a power play goal! And the Rangers lead 2-0. They needed him.
Look who's on the puck. Vancouver stands up, Kovalov stays wide, and Adam Graves with a beautiful shot all series long. He shot to the catching glove side. This time he said he's going to space his shots out. He goes to the stick side. What a pass. What a shot. Power play goal for the Rangers. And they're having a great time here celebrating in Madison Square Garden. Vancouver tried to stand up. Kovalov stayed wide.
Oh, my, did the Rangers make it look nice with some great skill play.
Look at him. Off the skate of Jelena. He's hip-checked by Leach. And a penalty is upcoming. Is this a penalty?
No, I believe it's offside.
Okay.
I thought I saw Jelena jump. Boom. Oh, my, we're seeing some good hitting. Both clubs involved. See Jelena try to turn and avoid the hit. Brian Leach came across with a good hit.
Final seconds of the first period. They're on their feet at Madison Square Garden. The Rangers have a 2-0 lead. One period complete in the game for the Stanley Cup.
Very intense, very hard fought, and he drew a penalty. The Rangers want the puck here quickly.
They don't get it. It's going to be a break for Trevor Linden. He moves to the net, and he scores! What an effort by Trevor Linden. He was the man who came on when Kirk McLean went to the bench, the extra skater on the delayed penalty, and the Canucks have scored to cut the Rangers' lead to 2-1. Pass across the flex to Linden. He controls, he moves in, a save, a skate save by Richter on a great shot by Trevor Linden, and an icing coming up on the Rangers. A hit in the corner, Rangers have Graves. Messier and Noonan for the power play. Zuboff and Leach. Noonan turns, puts it in front. Missed by Graves. Noonan's backhander save. And they score! Messier! It's a power play goal! Messier delivers again.
Just hard work once again. Zuba with the play to the front. Noonan to the front. Messier. And the puck is chipped in behind Kirk McLean. Adam Graves is there. Noonan's there. And I think Noonan will get credit as the defenseman in front put it in his own net. You'll see. Actually, it's McIntyre, the forward. He gets his hand on it, and it goes right through the legs of Kirk McLean.
Left it along the boards. In deep, Ronning comes out in front. Puck is loose, knocked aside. Didn't shoot. Save, Richter. Zuboff can't clear. Save, Richter on Ronning. And another save. And he's got the puck.
The puck at the net, and it's Mike Richter's turn. This save on Ronning was spectacular. Absolutely spectacular. He'll drop down. Watch him stack the pads. Oh, my, what a save.
Taken away. Nice setup for Courtnell. Save, Richter. Quinn couldn't play it. McTavish has the puck. 20 seconds in the period. Final seconds of the second period. Standing ovation. The Rangers are 20 minutes away. Rangers lead 3-1. That's the score in Times Square. Messier and Leach are there. Leach trying to lift it clear, taken away by Ronning. Ronning around the net. Ronning back pass. Brown couldn't tee up a shot. Ronning to Courtnell. He shot it. They score as it was batted in by Trevor Linden.
That's a beautiful goal. As far as pass work and power play goals go, this was an absolute beauty. Now it's 3-2.
Lead for Nathan Lafayette, moving in on Zuboff. He shoots, save, Richter. And McTavish got to the rebound. Another big save by Mike Richter.
He caught Richter moving, and that's why Richter went down on the original shot. He was moving and off balance. See him moving to his left? Now he kicks out the right foot.
3-2 Rangers leading it. Brown shoots, save by Richter. Tough low shot by Jeff Brown.
McLean is still in goal. There's 1:31 to go.
Okay. Will this crowd get a chance to celebrate? Defense is the chant. 1:31 on the clock. Lume moves in with a puck. Lume to the net. Knocked away by a sliding Leach. Noonan tied up by Adams. Lindsker is hit by Jelena. The puck in the corner comes loose, but Gregson blew the whistle, stopping play. With 1 minute to go in the third period, McLean heads to the bench. Extra man on for Vancouver. The puck cleared out. 55 seconds to go.
Vancouver's made a bad change. They haven't got the players
in order. Seven men on the ice. 45 seconds to go. Lume's got the puck. Shoots it in. Richter stops it. Zuboff plays it. Up into the crowd.
They have one man back, and that's Brown. Poirier's going to go ahead with quick hands. McTavis will have to nullify it. Here it is. The waiting is over. The New York Rangers are the Stanley Cup champions. And this one will last a lifetime. No more curses. This is unbelievable. These people have waited a long time. Fans, players, coaches. Unbelievable.
Let the celebration begin.
And on behalf of the former Rangers, thank you, 1994 Rangers. This is something special. Oh, remember this. Enjoy it.
To present the Conn Smythe Trophy to the 1994 Stanley Cup Playoffs Most Valuable Player, Commissioner Gary Bettman.
The winner of the Smythe Trophy as the most valuable player in the Stanley Cup playoffs is Brian Leetch.
The first American-born player to ever win the Conn Smythe Trophy, the sixth defenseman to ever be so honored.
Captain Mark Messier, come get the Stanley Cup.
Tina Turner's song, simply the best, blaring on the loudspeaker. That's the song the Rangers listened to before the game.
He came to New York 3 years ago to deliver the Stanley Cup. And there it is.
He's looking up at his family right now saying, I can't believe it.
How sweet it is.
Good evening, everybody. The waiting is over. Now, the biggest hockey game ever played in New York. Game 7, the Stanley Cup Final. Kirk McLean has never had an April, May, and June like this one in 94. He's played every game, this being his 24th, and he has played his heart out. If you wonder how the goalies deal with pressure, Mike Richter was saying yesterday, this is so exciting. It will not, Mike. It's going to end tonight.
1994 Stanley Cup Championship Final. One game. Winner takes all. We'll see who wants it the most this evening.
The Canucks get it out. Hunter didn't even play the puck, but was bumped and had gotten back inside the Ranger line again. Beach looking for room and finds a bit this time. Messier squeezing by. Messier cutting in there in the slot area.
Thank you.
the puck so well. Shoots it off back of the net. The Rangers are in there on it. Canucks trying to find it. It's Lume with a chance to shoot it out. Hooked it hard into the corner. They get it up to Burré. Burré coming in there. Two Rangers were back. And Burré just hangs onto it and kills something. Now there's a penalty coming up against New York. The train has gone to the bench. Puck is knocked to center.
To make it 2-1. Leach looked like he had the angle on him, but Linden had the one step to the inside and Leach couldn't have
it. 2-1 New York. Power play moving up. Zubov takes it over the line. Dumping it ahead for Graves. Graves is pumped in the corner. Three Canucks are back there against the three Rangers. They cannot move it out. Zubov, no shot. Nunes settled it. Here's Nunes. The backhand of Rutz goes.
We're going to see how the puck ever so slowly trickled through to make it 3-1.
That's his 12th goal of the playoffs, Mark Messier. Taking in for hooking. 4:16 of the third. Vancouver's second power play of the night. Leach shoots it down the ice easily. Shoot it in. They pour in after it. Messier on the ice trying to knock it off the boards to get it up to the line. Burré was waiting there. It goes to the corner to Ronning. He's around the net. Got a pass out. No shot. Back to Ronning. Centered it. Here's Cardinal. Score! Cardinal made the pass to Trevor Linden. And they get their power play goal. And again, the Vancouver Canucks are back in it.
Well, they will not. Awakened again on a Linden goal. The Canucks looked like they'd lost the puck in the Ranger zone. Got it back, and then a nice pass by Cortnell after he forced Leach to his knees on the shot block. Here it is right. There's the fake. Down goes Leach. Lovely little pass to Linden, and Richter had no chance whatsoever on it. These Canucks will not give up. Pat Quinn's team down 3-1 twice in the series. Came back to win one. Came back to tie this one up.
28.2 seconds left. Boy, is this tension or what?
And over on this side, they replace Linden and put Craven in there.
There they go. Here it is. Messier wins the draw. Can't get it out, though. Cortnell kept it in, took a shot. Leach went after it. Back in the net for the corner. The Rangers trying to clear it. It's in front again. Craven missed a chance. Back to the line. Burré shot to a crowd. Another shot by Craven. 12 seconds remaining. Vancouver now doing everything, trying to get one here. Rangers get it out. They get it out. And they're going to win. Well,
believe this, 1.1
to be a shot right off the faceoff. That's about the only play that's left in the Vancouver Canucks arsenal.
There's no use putting anybody in the slot. One guy who will roar in from the left boards and shoot the puck if it sits in the feet, and nobody wins the draw. You don't have time to win the draw and get the shot.
They'll drop the puck, and if it's not on the net, the Rangers will finally win the Stanley Cup. A lot has happened in 54 years, but for New York hockey fans, nothing. Nothing better than this. So here comes the faceoff, and let her rip, Manhattan. The New York Rangers have done it here on a hot June night.